Howdy, this is Lemmy with Dorman Products, here to talk to you today about our OE Fix catch can kit. Our catch can is designed to be an addition to the crankcase ventilation system on many light duty gas engines. The kit is reasonably universal. It's not engineered for any one vehicle, but as you'll see shortly, the pieces in the box make this a very easy installation on nearly any vehicle on the road today. Before we get into that installation and I tell you a bit more about this product though, let's discuss the confluence of factors that have suddenly made catch cans more than a fringe part for performance cars and why even workaday cars and trucks can benefit from the addition of one of these kits. Catch cans are placed in line in the PCV system to capture the air oil mist that exits the vehicle sump. The PCV system is one that worked very well over the years. However, a few vehicle changes have brought fresh challenges for the very early emissions control device. The first issue is forced induction. In 2000, one in every 100 vehicles was equipped with a turbocharger. In 2020, that number jumped to one in three. Simply, a turbo causes a heck of a lot more blowby, which pushes more air and oil through the system. Blowby is pressurized combustion gas that is slipped by the rings and pressurizes the crankcase. Low tension piston rings and engine oil with very low viscosity have been implemented in many vehicles too, with the goal of lowering losses to friction. However, both of these items contribute to increased blow-by too. Now, a little more oil than usual on the backs of the valves isn't the end of the world, except for yet another piece of technology that's becoming very common, gasoline direct injection, which you'll hear referred to as GDI. Normally, in a port injection system, the incoming air and fuel charge acts as a solvent, washing the backs of the valves. In a DI system, however, that oil simply stays in place and bakes right on, leading to expensive manual cleaning to avoid check engine lights, diagnostic trouble codes, and burnt valves caused by an inability to properly close. Decoking was a service I thought we'd left behind in the 50s. But here we are. Now, some OEMs think the solution to this scenario is to perform manual and chemical valve cleaning services at regularly scheduled intervals. We think there's a better way. Keep the oil from getting to where we don't want it in the first place. That's why we call this an OE fix. It's a preventative maintenance solution to prevent or reduce a more difficult repair. Many of you likely knew about some or all of those factors, but if you didn't, it should be very plain to see why something like a catch can definitely has a place under the hood of a modern automobile. Now let me walk you through our unit and explain why this is the one you want. I mean, start off with a can. A can is made from a pretty hefty chunk of aluminum, as you can see here. The can itself is knurled on the bottom to make emptying it easy, a task that does have to be performed from time to time. Now there's also a plug on the bottom if your mounting scenario doesn't make for easy removal of the can itself. And of course, everything here is anodized black for a seamless stock appearing installation. Now let's move on to the catch can head itself, which is really where the magic happens. This can features a two-stage oil mist separator. As oil-laden air enters the catch can assembly, the mixture hits this baffle here. Air passes on and oil is captured, but gravity takes it to the bottom of the can. Now, if there's any remaining oil, that gets captured when it hits this 50 micron filter over here where it condenses and falls down again. From here, the blow-by gases are fed back into their normal course of circulation, but a great amount of the engine oil has been removed. Barb fittings are pre-installed on the catch can head. Now, many kits stop here, but I think our kit really is a complete installation. Given the fact these are universal, of course, there's the possibility you may need to fabricate something, but I think the vast majority of installs will have every necessary item right in the box. Check out our mounting brackets. We have both flat and 90 degree brackets for installations on surfaces either parallel or perpendicular to the can axis. The slots on both brackets make finding a suitable mount pretty easy. Similarly, the round mount portion means there's a lot of rotational flexibility in how the catch can itself is installed and which way the hoses can be routed. Clamps and oil hose are included for a truly complete installation. All in all, you've got the ingredients you need to plumb a catch can in easily and have it look very, very stock. Now, if you're unfamiliar with the installation, you're effectively going to install this in line with the PCV gas path. The inlet and outlet on the catch can are marked for an easy installation. I generally mount my catch can, and then once I'm satisfied with the position, I'll procure any necessary fittings and then cut my hose and kind of plumb everything into place. Once I'm satisfied everything's working correctly and safely out of the way, I snug everything down, I'm pretty much done. The only maintenance is the periodic emptying of the catch can. We hope you like this new solution to keep costly mechanical or chemical valve cleaning at bay. And remember, if you need anything at all, the Dorman technical support team is always handy to help. Thanks for checking out our video on this catch can. I'm Lem, I'm out of here.